This is about a month since the last time we were here. It's about the third week in May. The flowers are starting to bloom. The weather's warming up. Snowpack is starting to melt, so we're into the growing season as far as the sugar beets. Since I talked to you last time, we've had three nice snow/rainstorms. The snow, when it comes down and a nice gentle rain, doesn't allow the ground to crust, so we didn't have any kind of problem with that as far as the emergence of the beets. We only had one night that was questionable whether it was cold enough to hurt the beets, so we've had a great 30 days since we talked last time about the crop germinating and coming up. You can see from here that the beets are starting, you can see the rows of the beets, and things are progressing very well. Okay, what we're going to do today is called cultivation, and before we cultivated, we went in there and we band sprayed a herbicide right over the row, and that's what we call a post-emergence herbicide application. We waited until the beets and the weeds were up. We went in there and we sprayed with a chemical herbicide to kill just the weeds and leave the beets. So the weeds in between the rows we don't worry about because we're going to cultivate those out, but the rows where the beets are real clean because the herbicide worked like a dream. First cultivation is something that has just been called that for a long time, and it is the first time we're going to go in and till the soil. We're going to go in there with some discs and some knives and some duck feet. We're going to leave about a 3-inch ribbon right over the row and cultivate everything else out, meaning we're going to stir the soil and undercut all the weeds. This is the same tractor we had before with the planter on there, but this time we have a cultivator on the back of it instead of a planter. So these implements interchange on the back of the tractor. Each tractor is designed with what we call a three-point, and it's just an attachment that each tractor has that allows us to interchange the different implements on the back. This is what we like to say, the first cultivation with the cultivator. We've got three separate bars that have tools that are attached to each bar, and they're adjustable, so each row can be individually adjusted to cut the weeds but not cover the beets. On the first bar we have a set of discs. You can see what's turning, and they're set at an angle, and what it does is it cuts the soil and moves it away so that the knife, which is the second tool here, this right here, can go in there, and as you can see it's flat and it undercuts all the weeds, and it aerates the soil and just kind of moves it around and kills the weeds and allows the soil to get a little more oxygen in it. And that helps the growth of the plant. And the last bar here is what we call the duck foot, and it just makes a mark so the next time we go through we have a mark to drive by. This bar right here, this white thing, is called a tunnel shield, and it's there just to protect the plant from getting covered up by dirt in case a clod or a slab or a slicker wants to fly out of any of these tools. It protects the little beets. This is the row we're going to cultivate in just a second. You can see the weeds that are growing up in between the rows. Different types of weeds that are growing in this field that this early spray didn't get, but I'm going to cultivate all these out. And when that gets done, that's all going to be nice and loose and mellow and great for the beets to grow in. I just wanted to show the ribbon that the discs leave. It's about a 3-inch wide. You can see it cuts that side and that way, and it leaves just the row. See, there's the knife right there. And it's just undercutting the dirt, and it's just cutting the roots off and killing the weeds and stirring the soil. See, there's the duck foot about an inch and a half to 2 inches underneath the soil. And it's just making that nice mark. See how the weeds have just been undercut, the root has been cut off, and the plants will die, just like cultivating your garden. We just finished our first cultivation, and the next operation is going to be in about a week. We'll be back to show how we thin the beets, to thin them out, because they're too thick to make any kind of a yield. So we're going to have to thin them out. So that's our next operation.